Alex. Welcome back to my channel. If you guys are new here, make sure to subscribe. And if you like these types of videos, make sure to give this a thumbs up and let me know down in the comments. In today's video, I'm going to be telling you guys what it was like living in Celebration, Florida. If you guys don't know what Celebration, Florida is, it is a Disney developed community. Don't get it confused with Golden Oak, because Golden Oak is a totally separate entity and Golden Oak is actually on Disney property, whereas Celebration was just like developed with Disney. Disney is not affiliated with it anymore. It just started out with Disney. I lived in Celebration from 2002 till 2014, and I will go ahead and insert pictures so you guys can see. So Celebration, Florida was part of Disney, and Disney had developed it. They were a part of the creation of Celebration. Just for the record, I don't live there anymore. Like I said, I moved out in 2014. My parents wanted to downsize, and basically our house helped pay for my college education, so that's awesome. And my parents wanted to downsize. We moved not too far away from Celebration, so all is good, and we really like our place here. But I really do miss our house in Celebration. It was so pretty, and you guys will see in the pictures and everything. First off, a lot of people don't know what Celebration is, and when I work at Universal, sometimes we have where we're from on our badges, and they're like, Celebration, where is that? And so I always have to tell them, like, oh, it's located right near Disney World. It's about probably at the most 15 minutes away from Disney. And also, the people that do know about Celebration are always shocked because they thought it was only for rich people. And don't get me wrong, like, the houses there are pretty expensive because of location and name brand and that sort of thing, but there's a wide range of incomes that live there. So the houses range in prices. There's a lot of apartments, but they're actually quite expensive if you live in one of the apartments. So I wouldn't recommend living in an apartment. They're also garage apartments. We had a garage apartment. So yes, there is like a stigma. I remember, like, at my school, people from Kissimmee, which is another like city here in Orlando. I live in Kissimmee. Some of the students from a Kissimmee school got transferred to Celebration school. Celebration has a high school and a K-8 school. So I went to the K-8 school until 7th grade, and then I moved to my art school, which was great. But some of the kids moved to Celebration K-8, and I just remember them calling us like Celebrats and stuff. And it wasn't very nice, but there was a stigma behind living in that location. But this brings me into the other point where I was just a kid since I grew up. It was just where my house was. I didn't really know anything else. Not that where we live now is bad or like run down or anything, because like we moved here when they were like building this house condo place for us. We got to pick out everything and have things customized to the way my parents and I wanted. But when you come from a place that like you just always known to a different place, it makes you feel more grateful that you got to grow up in such an awesome place. I always described it as a fake community because it looks fake, and I kind of took it for granted, to be honest. But now looking back on it and reflecting, I'm like, wow, I'm so grateful that I got to live there and grow up in such a cool place. There's no place in the world like it, and I'm being honest. I'm not trying to be like, oh, this is like the only place. No, but this is actually the only place. Name Celebration, and I don't know, I was watching this like documentary thing on like why there'll be no other place like Celebration and how Celebration has survived, quote unquote. Also, guys, I'm sorry if this video is pretty much everywhere. I have notes on my phone right here, and I just have like points that I want to hit. Another point on my list is when you live in a small town like that, everybody knows everyone. My mom was in Rotary, and my dentist and my eye doctor were in Rotary with her. There was just like so many intertwined relationships in Celebration, and not just like through business, but also interpersonal relationships. There was a lot of people that had affairs and stuff, and a lot of people like that got divorced. So this goes to show, like, you can live anywhere and like have as much money as you want, but there's still problems. If you were to visit a place like Celebration, like, you would not think that anything could go wrong. You would think life is perfect, but there was a lot of people that we knew personally and everything that had a lot of problems, and it was just really, really sad. That just goes to show and prove that no economic status or no location on earth is a place that's always perfect. Yeah, that was another point I really wanted to get across because it's insane. My parents and I kind of had this theory that if people were going through like hard times and maybe in their relationship or like job or something, that they would move to Celebration because they think that all of their problems are going to be solved because they live in this perfect place. But that's totally not the case at all because their problems did not escape them. And I could probably name off five people that I know that probably fit into that mold, which is insane. When we lived there, we did actually, in fact, call it the bubble, because everything that you needed to live off of, like a grocery store or a gas station, someone's business or job could be there, your house is there, entertainment is there. You really did not have to leave Celebration to like really do anything. Like clearly you could travel and stuff, but everything that you needed to live and function, you did not have to leave Celebration. And that was pretty cool. Everything was really convenient. Also, to go kind of with the bubble, we had these things called NEVs. NEV stands for Neighborhood Electric Vehicle. And what that was, it was kind of like a golf cart, but electric. It's kind of hard to explain, so obviously I'll probably insert a picture here. They were so cute. They went 25 miles an hour, and ours was so cool. I don't know if I actually have a picture of it, but I will try to hunt one down and show you guys our exact NEV. Obviously, it matched our house. It was a black, white, and gray, and Sherry loved that thing so much. And the dance studio I started out with was actually in Celebration. Again, inside the bubble. Sherry would pick me up from school in our NEV, and then we would drive to the dance studio and drop me off. It ran on electric, so we saved on gas with that, and it was just really cool. Obviously, there's places that you couldn't drive your NEV because the speed limit was above 25, but mostly in Celebration, the speed limits are 25 miles per hour. So most everywhere you could drive your NEV, and it was so cool. Oh, it was so sad when we had to sell it, but I think we just sold it because we weren't using it a lot, and my dance studio that I moved to wasn't in Celebration, so we weren't really getting a lot of use out of our NEV. But it was so convenient when we were trick-or-treating or had like a 4th of July event or anything like that. It was amazing because you had these special parking spots that you could park your NEV in. This probably sounds like a fantasy to some of you guys, and I know it's sounding kind of like ridiculous, but yeah, there were actual parking spots for these things. The only bad thing that I actually remember about our NEV was that when it was really hot out and you were getting into the NEV from like going to the pool or anything like that, it would really burn your butt. That was the only thing, because the seats were kind of like leather. This leads me into my next point, and there was a lot of events. Probably more events than today. There was so many events, like every holiday, like Memorial Day, 4th of July, fall, Christmas. There was either a parade or a downtown event or booths set up, kind of like a market. There was like a Sunday farmers market that a lot of people went to, and you would see people around town. It was just really cool, and I love and miss those types of events. They still do those events, I believe, but they're not as good as when I was growing up, because this leads me into my next point. Celebration has expanded so much. It's so large now, and it's kind of lost that small town vibe because there's just so many people. And a lot of the people that I knew growing up and everything have actually moved out. I feel like we moved there at the right time, and I grew up at the right time there. It's just so different now, and it's actually kind of sad because I feel like Celebration is kind of like going downhill. Both my optometrist and dentist are still there, and I still go to them. My optometrist's granddaughter was in one of my classes in grade school. That's the type of small community it was. It's kind of cool because I still get to like touch base with her grandma and like hear the news on her and everything. So the really good thing about Celebration, even though it was a place that you had to have probably a little bit more income to live. There was a wide range of houses and a wide range of options to choose from, and there was never like a rich area because it was all like sprinkled out in this town. So you could live in like a little townhouse, and then right next door could be like this giant mansion. That's kind of how they wanted to lay it out. So everything was kind of like uniform, but also had like sprinkles of like mansions and everything. There's this one street, I actually don't really know what it's called, but it is primarily where the big mansions lie, which is really cool. But most of Celebration is intermixed with different houses, different styles, everything like that. There would be people that would like drive around and like critique your area. So if it wasn't up to par, you would be hearing it. You would get fined and stuff. They were pretty strict, but I understand because they were trying to keep up an image. And to keep up an image, you need to have strict rules and everything. So I totally get that. They were just so picky about like grass, the littlest things. So that's why my parents also wanted to move here, because it was just so much nicer and we don't really have to take care of all of that stuff on our own now. It's kind of like built into our homeowners association fee, which is amazing. If you want any more details, you can definitely ask me in the comments down below. But I'm going to now kind of talk about like what my house looked like. We lived in a white house with like black detailing, so we had like black shutters. It was pretty much the same size of our place now. It even kind of looks the same because all of our furniture is the same. All the colors are the same. Really, it looks exactly the same. But what was really cool about our house in Celebration was our pool. We had a great pool. My parents actually got to design it, and it was black. So it was a black pool, and all my friends, when they would come over, they'd be like, oh my gosh, a black pool. That's so cool. They would always say, I've never seen a black pool. I'm like, well, now you have. And to me, it was kind of like shaped like a dog bone with a bite taken out of it. And I don't know if my parents did that on purpose, because we did have a dog back then. The pool came way before the dog, so they probably were not thinking about dogs. It had a cool light that actually burned out within a year. We never got it replaced. We also had a 3-car garage, which was behind the pool. This was our house. This was the pool backyard area, and then we had our garage. I don't know if that's making any sense, but on top of our garage, we had a garage apartment. So it was kind of like an apartment thing. And people were like, oh my gosh, you have like 2 houses. And honestly, it was pretty cool because when we had guests over, they would just stay in the garage apartment. They wouldn't stay in our house. But I remember most of the time when I was older and everything, we rented it out. So actually another person lived there, and they would park their car like in the back alley. I know this is sounding like so weird. They would pay us rent and everything, and like electric and like utilities and all of that was like built into that fee that we would charge them. And I really wish I had like video footage and everything, but I really only have pictures of our house. So anyway, that is pretty much it for this video. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. If you guys have any questions, leave them in the comments down below, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.